Ever since I was younger, I had a fascination with mysteries. The obscure, the unsolved, and the unknowable. From interesting to disturbing, harmless to dangerous. Join me as I uncover rabbit holes and track down information on a plethora of topics you may know little about. This is Atlas Investigates. Hello everyone, I'm Atlas, and this is the Chronological Chris Chan Iceberg. And it's snowing outside. Welcome back. Once again, just to get the explanation out of the way, an iceberg chart is a collection of information on a specific topic ranked based on how obscure and or disturbing the facts are. And Chris Chan is a person on the internet that many people are familiar with, or have at least heard of. He holds the title of the most documented person on the internet because of the sheer amount of facts that are available regarding his exceedingly strange life. This iceberg was created by the user Piccadilly on icebergcharts.com and was posted on the 8th of February, 2022. This is part 9 of this chronologically organized iceberg, and I encourage you to go to my channel and watch the first 8 parts if you haven't already. While we're on the subject, I'll encourage you to like the video, subscribe to the channel if you want to see more, and leave a comment if you have something to say. I do read them all. If you'd like to see more frequent updates from me, or just listen to what I have to say, you can follow my Twitter, which will be linked in the description and be listed on screen right now. If you've already done all that, then let's begin. The Trolling Era, 2007 to 2010. As usual, before we get into things, I want to let you know that there are a few overlapping sagas that occur during this time period. In this episode, we're going to be covering part of the Clyde Cash saga, part of the Gameplay saga, and much of the Liquid Chris saga. In order to keep things chronological, I'm going to go over the events as they happen in the timeline, as opposed to going saga by saga. So keep an eye out for the title that'll appear on screen and let you know which saga the event I'm talking about is connected to. Let's begin. Sonichu Game. I'm sort of including this one in order to set the scene. In a video uploaded on July 26th, 2009, called Christian Weston Chandler's Exciting Announcement of Sonichu and Addressing Things, Liquid Chris lets his audience know that he has officially entered into an agreement with Nintendo to create and distribute games based on his original Sonichu characters. He also calls out the fake Christian Weston Chandler that has been trolling him. And we get another call from the mysterious Casey, who has apparently been in contact with Liquid Chris since her last appearance.
Captain's Log, Stardate, July 26th, 2009.
Hello, my loyal fan base. I have some exciting news to be announced. I just recently heard from an independent game company who wishes to pick up my Sonichu character and make it into a video game. This is going to be the true and honest Sonichu game. It is in the works, and I signed on a very tasty contract with them for a large sum of money, which I do not feel overly comfortable discussing right now, because this large amount of money may influence how the women see me as a person, and prevent me from finding my true sweetheart. I did find this on my answering machine when I got up in the morning this morning.
Hi, it's Casey again. Thanks for returning my phone call. I'm really sorry I missed yours. I was a little apprehensive about calling someone who I've never talked to from online, but, you know, I thought you might be different, and I'm really glad that I was right. So yeah, I would love to talk again. I'm out of class for the rest of the day, so just give me a call back. I'll be around. So I can't wait to talk to you. Peace.
But, you know what? I am very excited today because of my lifelong dream is finally coming true.
Hooray!
The, Derm Company has told me, that as of, right now, they want me to, not give away too much, info, and they have me sign a NDA, which is a, as they put it, a non-disclosure agreement. However, they did agree to allow me to tell you the title of the game and what system it's, coming out for. Yeah. It says here that they are very pleased to pick up my series and will be showing it off at the Austin GDC Game Developers Conference in September. Yeah, so just want y'all to know that it's coming along well for me. Despite all those slanderous trolls and imposters, my dreams are finally coming true. Look for Sonichu, the Crystal Chronicles, and Store Near You exclusively for the Xbox 360. While I do not personally own an Xbox 360 yet, they have promised me to give me one for free, and have assured me that it is not as bad as I thought in the past. To that overweight troll who keeps trying so hard to impersonate me, please understand, I am a high-functioning autistic male, and please stop interfering with the sales of my Sonichu franchise. It is my main source of income, and my parents need to be supported on it. Don't be so naive to think that I don't know what you're up to. Well, I hope y'all are having as good of a week as I have. To my true supporters, thank you and peace. And to the rest of you slanderous trolls, it's my game-making foot.
The slanderous Clyde Cash is harassing me again. This is the title of a follow-up video to another video posted on July 27th in which Liquid Chris parodies the video in which Solid Chris is forced to admit that he is gay, uploaded during the Julie saga. In this second video, Liquid Chris reveals a shocking bit of information. Clyde Cash is, in actuality, not dead. In addition, he was the one who had forced Liquid to upload that fake admission of gays. Included in the description of the video is a recording of a phone call made between Liquid Chris and Clyde Cash.
Hello. Some of you may have seen the video that was posted last night, saying that I was of the wrong orientation. That video was done by me in order to protect my mother's retirement account and credit card accounts. You want to know who's doing it? I'll tell you who's doing it. I'll have the link in the sidebar there. Because there's proof that it was the slanderous Clyde Cash who has been trolling me for such that long time. Mr. Clyde, we will not be crashed into slumber by your heinous antics and whatnot. To my loyal fans, peace, and have a good day.
Of course. Breaking into your mumble chat as always. So, I do believe your mother's missing spirit.
Yeah, how'd you know about that? She's her retirement funds are being siphoned off. Do you know anything about that?
No, I don't. I only know the name of the guy who's doing it.
I think you actually do.
What?
I think you actually do.
No, I only know the name of the guy who's doing it. Do you want to know his name?
Yeah, what is it?
It's Clyde Cash.
See, I knew that you were stealing it, and I am not going to let this pass, because once you intrude on a life life of my family, you are never going to hear the end of it. Too many crooks.
What are you going to do about it? What are you going to do about it?
I don't know what I'm going to do about it right now. I'm probably going to, call the police or something.
You don't even know where I live.
Yeah, I mean, I could probably figure it out.
Letter to Michael Snyder. As part of Chris's quest to discover who the very first troll was, he wrote this letter to Michael Snyder, the manager of the game place, which I will read aloud now. July 27th, 2009. Michael Snyder, The Game Place, 243 Ridge McIntyre Road, Charlottesville, Virginia. Michael, it has been about 1 year, 1 month, 2 weeks, 14 days, since you kicked me out of my weekly volunteer work at your store with at the Pokemon Trading Card Game League. Fiddlesticks! The feelings of that shameful event between you, my mother, Barbara Ann Weston Chandler, and me, both of me, Christian of now, and Christopher of the 80s. I want to let you know that I no longer hold hard emotions against you of that day, as well as a few Fridays before when you boasted no, we play. There were children without the Electivire, Magmortar, and Surfing Pikachu. Sigh. So I will ask you again, please let me back into the place. But now I get to the main point of handwriting this letter today. You know well not only of the Encyclopedia Dramatica page against me, but of my infinite swarm of countless internet bullies and trolls who, quoting Stan Bush, trying to break your, my, spirit, keeping you, me, down. But I fight them all and emerge victorious after fighting for the things you, I, know are right. I digress. I am looking up and searching for the very first quick troll. The very first individual who ranted against me, Sonichu, and Rosechew. Enclosed is a copy of my list of suspects from as early as October 2007. You are at the top of the list. I have already informed my church's pastor, pastoral counselor, and our Charlottesville detective, working on stopping these trolls. I want you to be God-watching honest with me, Michael Snyder. Are you one of these trolls? For reasons before November 2007, why did you hate me or troll me? The wee thing does not count, because that happened June 2008. What did I ever do to you? Why troll me above all more successful or less successful people? Or in short, for you to respond with a minimum 500-word essay, what the fuck? Please reply via handwritten letter only, as quickly as possible. Have a good day. Peace, Christian W. Chandler. I find it hilarious that Chris demands a minimum 500-word essay from Michael explaining his actions, and thinks he's in any sort of position to ask for anything at all from Michael after acting like a psycho in his store for months on end. The Quickival War. I think that's how you pronounce that. This is the name that Crystorians have given to the conflict between Solid Chris and Liquid Chris. While both parties have been taking shots at each other in videos prior to this point, I'm going to call July 29th the official start of the war for the purposes of this video. On this date, Chris uploaded a video called Quick More Than a Feeling, in which he simply plays along to the song More Than a Feeling by Boston on Guitar Hero, playing along terribly and hitting the whammy bar way too much. In direct response, Liquid Chris filmed and uploaded a very similar video, except in this version, he actually plays a real acoustic guitar, already demonstrating that he has more talent than Solid Chris. He ends the video by saying, "Take that, imposter," and beckoning to the camera menacingly. Solid Chris would leave an angry comment on the video, and Liquid would reply, causing the two to get into a heated argument in the comments section. Ian Brandon Anderson. Because Chris's latest YouTube account was called IBA Chandler, trolls began a rumor that this was a clue to his real name. Instead of Christian Weston Chandler, trolls began to say that Solid Chris's real name was actually Ian Brandon Anderson, supporting the idea that Liquid Chris was the real Christian Weston Chandler. As you might guess, Solid Chris did not like these rumors at all. Quick update, 29th July, 2009. After the two musical videos were uploaded, Chris filmed and posted this update video. In it, he tries to prove to everyone that he is not, in fact, Ian Brandon Anderson. In the original version of the video, an extended cut he would upload on the same day, and an addendum video, Chris tries to prove his identity by showing his driver's license, referencing the Rollin' and Trollin' and It's Ugh videos, and speaking in his garbled version of Spanish, asking Liquid Chris to try and prove his own identity. Here is the extended video and the addendum.
Alright, Captain's Log, stardate, July 29th, 2009. Let's get this over with right off the bat. Dispelling rumors and making a few points. There are no official Sonic Your Rose 2 merchandise yet. Whatever you're buying right now, it's fake, especially from the damn black, brown-striped imposter posing as me. And I can best prove who I am. Close up, zoom in on me. Right, my driver's license. With the customer number censored? Can you copy front and back, thickness, back, front, reflective, Virginia, if you can see it? I think not. I think not. Ignore all YouTube videos portraying me in a wrong sense, especially if it is not on my true YouTube account, this one, IBA Chandler. Playing off of my father's license plate, a little bit. IB Mr. C. A lot of Mr. C's, I'm an important C. Mr. Chandler, IBA Chandler. And yes, it is true. I have called myself a troll because I'm trolling my trolls back. So, in a sense, I am a troll to those trolls only. I am not a troll to any of the true, honest people out there. I just, because of the internet and whatnot, it's hard to tell a difference. So, if you are not a troll, and you know you're not, it does not apply to you. Otherwise, you know you're a troll. I'm trolling you back. And it's okay to be stupid sometimes. Stupid. Damn dirty song. Well, it is not okay to be homosexual. I will personally not judge any individual of that one trait. I'm willing to be friends with homosexuals. And let me make it clear, I will not tolerate any further damn dirty stupid questions questioning my dang orientation. I, Christopher Christian Weston Chandler, am straight. Have good faith in me. And to all my loyal, true viewers, fans, everybody, you will be rewarded. Look up the history of the private villa of corrupted citizens. For one, a full extended story from my head and my hands tight on the new, the official, as of 2009, the new official CWC's Sonic Unleashed site. I leave that with you. Peace and have a good day. Captain's Log, stardate, May 29th, 2009. Ay! Impostor en rayos de marrón! Yo tenía dos años de español en mi escuela secundaria, Manchester High, con mi señora bonita. Y yo recibí durante las clases el apodo que yo usé para mi internet, Ricardo. Mi nombre fue Ricardo en las clases de español. Recuerde el Pokésite de RWC con CWC's Pokésite 2, CWC's Bionicle site, CWC's Hot Wheels site, and the original CWC Sanchi site. Yo voy a hacer una apuesta que tú, el impostor, no graduaste desde tu escuela secundaria. En serio? Yo, el verdad, Christopher Christian Ricardo Weston Chandler, no solamente gradué de Manchester High con mi título. Mi título de basketball en mi año de freshman. Stupido. Tú eres estúpido. No solamente con años, pero con mis puntos de honor bueno. ¿Y cómo fue escribe en los cómicos de Sancho, Roshu y yo? Yo fui a Piedmont Virginia Community College para mi título y certificado para computer aided drafting and design. Que yo diplomado muy bueno y recibe en June 2006. ¿Dónde está tu título de Manchester High, tu título de Piedmont, de tu certificado de Piedmont de Computer and Drafting and Design? ¿Dónde están? Tú no tienes. ¿Verdad? Tú no tienes. Yo tiene. Yo soy el verdad Christopher Christian Ricardo Weston Chandler. Entonces, por favor, para todos los veces en el futuro y ahora, dejar de este juego maldito, impostor tonto y estúpido. También, me presente. Responde en español bueno. Si no que bueno, tú no eres el verdad. Tú eres el impostor. Responde en inglés, no es bueno. No es bueno, tonto impostor. En rayos de marrón. Paz.
Liquid Chris would post a response video on the 29th as well, in which he outdoes Chris by speaking Spanish, French, German, and Japanese. He also claims that he has officially entered into a relationship with Casey, made amendments with Clyde Cash, and says that the production of the Sonichu game is going well, among other things.
Hola, este es el verdadero Ricardo Weston Chandler. Imposter NL Pequeño Chaleco. Yo no solo comprender su último video, pero tiene un excelente dominio de la idioma de Cervantes. Puedo establecer mi identidad. Hablan muchos idiomas. Je parle aussi français, comme je l'ai pris d'ans de français de mes années lycée à Manchester. Avec ma jolie professeure de français. J'ai obtenu mon diplôme avec mention. J'ai même un certificat à partir du moment où j'ai été l'assistante responsable de l'équipe au PVCC. Habe ich zwei Jahre lang von Deutschland und bin in der Lage zu sprechen fließend Deutsch nicht zu erreichen. Habe ich den Zertifikat in CAD. Usana ja otoha. Seka puhu asumeha. Aso ni wa tadashi kris naraba to yomeru kare daga. Kanomandai wa subete korera no gengo de oto suru. Hitsuyo ga arimasu. I wish to go over a number of things, but first I'd like to tell you. Hello, my sweet Casey. My sweetheart, Casey, and I are gonna be together forever. And I love her with my heart. And we met because of Sanichu. She will be my caring girl, and I will never leave her. We have already gone out on our first date. First date! Under more important things. I wish to, as a high-functioning autistic male, to explain autism briefly to y'all. Public service announcement, if you will. Autism is a mental block where it's hard to do things, and even the slightest of things that you don't want to do will give you stress. When you are stressed as an autistic, it's just easy to fall asleep. Asperger's syndrome is something that is very similar to autism. People with Asperger's take things very literally, which sometimes is another mental block to understanding others or the ladies. Both Asperger's and autism start from an early age, in which you are diagnosed and given documents proving it. My name is Christian Weston Chandler, and I swear on my autism, that these things must be remembered. Another thing, I have made my rectum with Clyde. I have rectified things with Clyde. He has apologized for taking money from my mother's retirement account, and has apologized for torturing me in the past. I thank you, Clyde, and this could be a start of a beautiful friendship. I do not have to worry about him you know, trolling me anymore. And finally, found a shoe. The Crystal Chronicles. The game is coming along so well that I've been able to print out so many images that the designers have sent me. So, I'm doing pretty well right now. I was able to buy my father, Robert Chandler, a new axe for his woodworking hobby, and I have bought my Pokemon flute for my mother, Barbara Chandler, for her music, and I have bought myself just a whole bunch of rare Transformers toys and animation programs off of eBay.
Autobots, defeat those Decepticlones!
Peace. And another thing, that the Dark Horse Publishers has offered me to create my own template for a official Sonichune magazine. So why don't you take a look here. The rapid fast news dash.
I love you, Casey.
That goatee will grow back. This is a video in which, in an attempt to further prove his identity, Chris shaves off the goatee he'd been sporting for quite some time now. He does this while sitting on his bed, meaning that all his hairs fell onto either his shirt or his mattress. Plus, he doesn't use any water or shaving cream. He just raw dogs that shit. Unbelievable. That had to hurt like hell. In the background, the song Lift Up Your Eyes by the Christian rock band Planet Shakers can be heard playing. SingStar Challenge Announcement. In a ploy to best Liquid Chris, Solid Chris uploaded a video on July 31st challenging him to a duel of sorts. According to Chris, this challenge would involve the two of them picking a song out of their respective libraries and singing them on camera without any printed lyrics or karaoke equipment, and with the MP3 playing behind them. The song selections also had to be in English lyrics. The entries would be judged by a panel of 6 people, 3 picked by Solid Chris, and 3 picked by Liquid Chris. While a specific prize for winning the challenge was not given, the assumption here is that the winner would be named the Superior Chris. Solid Chris's judges were Kim Wilson, aka Emily, Kate Bay, the supposed friend of Samantha Thaddeus, who Chris remained in contact with, and an unknown man. Liquid Chris's judges were his new girlfriend Casey Devoria, Spaz Kid, the creator of the Sonichu the Animated Series YouTube videos, and a man named Seth.
Alright, Christian, Mr. Brownstriped Imposter, since you have been able to accept and complete my question challenges, it is time to issue a new challenge. I challenge you in a SingStar competition. The rules are simple. We are to each pick one song out of our own library, our own playlist, and sing them verbatim without any printed lyrics and without any karaoke equipment. And I will show you right now how fair I am. My room layout. No karaoke equipment whatsoever. And also, we must have the MP3s played behind us, so therefore, no musical instruments whatsoever in any video. And only in song number 5, no song before, we will allow each other to pick one song and challenge the other with that song. And the deadline for each uploaded song is approximately 24 hours from the previous one. So your song number 1, the deadline for that will be approximately 24 hours after I upload and start my first song. So, with that, we will soon be commencing with the first track, Sonic Boom. And with that, I will be showing you my little layout. My speakers are over there. My camera will sit here. The only thing that I ask another way in this, no separate microphones, but only the microphones on our webcams. Oh, I forgot one thing. You may use your MP3 player of choice. My PSP is mine, attached to my speakers. You may show me yours in your first video, Mr. Christian. Any mutiny against the rules I have set forth in this video will be not countable, and you will have to do it all over again. And so with that, no imported music, which means no Japanese, no Spanish, no German, no other country language, only English. Shame. Would love to play Sailor Star or Flame Sniper. And also, once a song has been sung of that specific title from that specific band, it will not be reusable in a future song. Neither by you, neither by me. I abide by the rules. Game on. Abre la contesta!
The Sing Star Challenge. Liquid Chris would accept Solid Chris's challenge, and so the contest would take place on YouTube over the next few days, spanning from July 31st to August 6th. The songs that Solid Chris chose to cover were Sonic Boom by Pistache, Don't Say You Love Me by M2M, Autumn Goodbye by Britney Spears, and The Touch by Stan Bush. Liquid Chris's chosen songs were You're Pitiful by Weird Al Yankovic, The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air by Will Smith, Heaven by Bryan Adams, and Think Twice by Eve Six. For the final round, each opponent chose a song for the other to perform. Liquid told Solid to sing Smell Yo Dick by Risqué, and Solid told Liquid to sing Lift Up Your Eyes by Planet Shakers. During this contest, Liquid Chris is actually not portrayed by the same person as in all the other videos. Instead, Christopher's twin brother John, who is actually a musician, did the singing. Prank calls. During the Sing Star Challenge, a troll decided to mess with Chris by placing an ad for Chris's 94 Ford Escort, aka Sanchu, on Craigslist, and listing it as being for sale. This led to several prank calls from trolls. Recordings exist of calls made by trolls Nick Dunbar, Jack Thaddeus, and, surprisingly, Blue Spike.
Hello?
Hello, is this Chris?
Yes, this is Christian Chandler. How may I help
Hi.
You?
I'm calling in regards of your Craigslist ad. It says here that you're selling a 94 Escort for $400.
That's a That is a fake ad. Somebody else put that up there without my consent as a prank.
Are you sure? Yes, I am. I am
100% positive. It's a fraud. Somebody else put it up there. I've already sent a complaint to Craigslist, so go look somewhere else for a car.
Are you sure I can't convince you otherwise, sir? I mean, I have a
perfectly good... I am sure.
You're sure? I have a perfectly good Xbox 360 right here, right next to me.
Shut up!
Okay. Excuse me, sir?
Hello. Yeah, reach this up on Christian Weston Chandler. I'm sorry I cannot answer right now, but please leave your name, message, and telephone number. I'll get back to you as soon as possible. And I was advised heavily by my publicist and my lawyers to not do any interviews or documentaries whatsoever. Even in, because I got so much reputation at stake at the current time. Also, if this is a troll trying to troll me back, do you think I'm a trolling stupid? I'm not trolling stupid. You're trolling stupid. Have a good day.
Hey there, is this Mr. Chandler?
Yes, it is.
Good evening, sir. I'm calling in regards to the Craigslist about the 94 Escort.
That thing was put up there. It was a fake. I have not put up there myself. Somebody's using my name, my address, and it's just a prank. It's not real.
All right, no reason to get all upset about it, sir. Okay, I have a pretty good condition Xbox.
I am serious. It is not for sale. It never will be for sale. And would you think I would give up my car for a blatantly stupid Xbox? H-E-S.
Yes, I can spell, sir. Do you prefer the PlayStation 3?
I'm not selling my car. Good night.
But it was my brother's, and now he's dead.
Hi there. I'm sorry to bug you this evening, buddy, but is this Mr. Chandler?
Yes, it is.
I heard you had my bike. A 94 Ford bike? I'll trade you an Xbox for my bike.
The car is not for sale. That ad was a fake
bike.
Somebody else put up as a joke.
And
put my address, my name on it. It was a joke. My car is not for sale. Goodbye.
This isn't a joke, buddy. My bike.
Identity theft. With the assistance of Kate Bay, Chris gained access to Liquid Chris's email account and began impersonating him in order to communicate with Casey, Liquid Chris's girlfriend. While she was aware that this was happening, she played along with Chris's ruse. On August 3rd, Solid Chris and Casey would actually have a phone call in which Solid pretends to be Liquid. Apparently, under the impression that she would not notice the difference in his voice. Again, Casey plays along, and Chris tries to get her to come to his house to meet the real Christian Weston Chandler. To put this into perspective, Chris is attempting to convince a girl to meet him at his house under false pretenses. It doesn't matter that Casey knows what he's up to, he thinks that this is real and is doing it anyway. One highlight of this phone call is when Solid Chris, still pretending to be Liquid Chris, defends his own haircut to Casey when she makes fun of it.
Well, you know, the imposter's never going to get anyone anyway. He's not as awesome as you, you know. I just fell for you right off the bat. I mean, he's just such a fatty, and you're thin and you're hot. And your Madonna is so much better.
Oh, yes. Yeah. That's not the real deal.
And your flowing locks. I mean, come on. What's with that haircut?
Oh, come on. You know, I bet his mom probably cut his hair, and I think it looks good on him, actually. I like his haircut. I probably would get my haircut that way, you know, in the near future.
You're going to get your mom to cut your hair? Oh, Chris, oh, you. I get it. You're joking.
I might need, but then again, I might be serious. You never know.
Well, you are full of surprises.
I am full of surprises. I am full of surprises, woman. You know me. I'm full of surprises.
I know you. I definitely know you. So tell me about some of these surprises. Spoil me, please.
Okay. Surprises. Oh, yeah. you got you know, you'll see my house. It'll definitely look so much familiar to you. I mean, if you looked anywhere on the internet, you'll recognize my house.
Yearbook. On August 3rd, after uploading his cover of Britney Spears' Autumn Goodbye, Solid Chris uploaded an extra video in which he goes through his old school yearbook, confirming that he was in all of them, and challenging Liquid Chris to do the same in order to prove his identity, as well as talk about his parents and reveal what their jobs were. Chris was really shooting himself in the foot here, since information of his own parents' jobs and backgrounds had been made public by himself for quite some time prior to this point, making them very easy to impersonate. Liquid Chris also parodies Solid Chris's Secret Weapon video, showing a picture of Chris standing in front of his camera in his mother's underwear and mocking him.
Before I give it off again, let me go through a brief bit of history. Some of my yearbooks. 90 to 1995 in Providence, Middle. Let's look it up. Christian Chandler, all the way over here. So many memories. Oh, look, some of the faculty. Very good. Now, let's see if we can find my favorite faculty member in this book. My favorite teacher, who gave me so much inspiration. So much inspiration. Here we are. Remembering you is easy. Now, 1996. Let's take a look in here. Ocho Grado. Oh, yeah. There I am. Right there. Christian Chandler. In there. And now we go back to high school. 1997. My freshman year. Now, let's see. B's. B, B, C, D, E, F, G. Oh, here we are. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. Who's that handsome fella? Oh, and I think there's a little bonus feature in here that I definitely can recall from a good time. Just give me a moment. Okay, I found the page. Same book. Here's a group of pictures. Here's a group. Row one on the bottom. Yeah, I can't make it out over the camera, but that's me right there. Varsity basketball team my freshman year. Joseph Emery on one end there. Good old Joe. Let's see. 1998 book. I would be a sophomore this year. Speaking of which, have you taken a good look at that imposter? He is so sophomoric. He's gotta be like 13 or 16. Check his real ID, police people, please. Okay, sophomore. At this time, I would have been sophomoric. By way back then. Here I am, right there on the end. Next book. 1999. Manchester High, still. The junior year. Let's see, junior. Oh, yes, here we are. 1, 2, 3, 4. There I am. 1, 2, 3, 4. There I am. And senior year. Senior. I turned 18 in the year 2000. And let's see how good I looked. I looked great. Handsome little fella. and some 18-year-old back in the year of 2000 graduated with my class of Y2K. Tiffany, thank you for that dance senior prom. I will repay you at her reunion. Now, I have a new question to put forth to the man in brown. If you have your books, you may show them, whether they be counterfeit or not. You'd just be gnawing another nail on your coffin for the Imperial Police to find. But anyway, tell me about your mother and your father. What are their jobs? What are their occupations? Tell me the details in a separate video when you do your third song. Your play.
Captain's log, stardate, Monday, August 3rd, 2009. My mother is Barbara Ann Chandler, born October 1st, 1941. She was a secretary for a good many years and retired in 1998. And my father said that she looked just like Liz Taylor when she was young. I want to say that, my father is Robert Franklin Chandler Jr. Born on the 4th of September 1928. He worked at General Electric and has 7 patents. You shouldn't be making me do this. I mean, this has relatively nothing to do with the singing competition whatsoever. But yeah, I'll just continue to do it anyway. My mother met my father at a bar. My mother used to work as secretary at Virginia Power. She retired, and took up, music. And, that means the, Pokemon flute that I bought her just recently will come in handy. My father was drafted and he went to Korea before it was split into two nations, and he went to college on the GI Bill. He studied pre-engineering and then moved on to Auburn University to earn his engineering degree. He worked at Western Electric and then got the offer from General Electric. But anyway, he has made many patents, including these. But anyway, he is so smart that he's on Google. Yeah. So he is now retired and chops down wood in spare time. How about you, imposter? You don't even appreciate your parents. So there. You troll. Now for something completely different. I have confirmed the true name of the slanderous imposter, and that his real name is IBA, Ian Brandon Anderson. And a big detail you might have not overlooked. I have your mugshots. I can't even stand to look at it! Look at those double D cups! You're a freak! Ha 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 ha! I scoff at you, you ugly freak! And to his latest video saying that he is true because he got trolled by figures such as Clyde Cash, I got trolled by Clyde Cash just not last week. That doesn't prove anything, and you are still a coward for trying to make this contest less important than it already is. Whoever wins is the true Christian Weston Chandler. The end. No dogs about it. Peace. Have a good time.
Quick thank you, smiley face. After Liquid Chris's response, Chris posted this video, thanking the trolls for their extensive documentation of his life. He asserts that, due to their record-keeping, there is a massive amount of proof definitively stating that he is, in fact, the real Christian Weston Chandler. In this video, he also alludes to the supposed real name of Liquid Chris, which he believes to be Jeff. This was fed to him by Kate Bay as misinformation.
Captain's Log. Stardate, April 3rd, 2009. I have had the revelation. I now see the truth. I see the truth behind the reason why the trolls troll me. Why they have been, and why they're still doing it, and all the like. Not just because they're bored. Not just because they want information. Not just because they want to get to know me. Not just because they've been emotionally hurt themselves. So many details that could be supposed for all the reasons to be listed. But the trolls are there to document the truth. Granted, they twist them around for their own evil ways, trying to make the individual look bad. Still, document the truth. And with that, I would like to say the following assortment of words that I have felt in my heart. It is good to have my own trolls. They may try and sometimes succeed in getting true, hard, honest information from one, and they may later twist the truth for their evil purposes, just like the paparazzi. And yet, they still document the truth. And that text, audio, photographic, video, etc. type of information is what separates the imposters from the real, true, honest individual. Just as I am posing in my shirt, in my coat I have worn on my 25th birthday future message video, I wear it now because I thank you, trolls. I thank you for documenting the truth. I thank you for keeping it real and separating me from the false people. I also thank Encyclopedia Dramatica. Granted, slanderous, still some truth. And the original truth is documented in there somewhere. In the history. Granted, that is as much as you will have gotten from me, and all that sort of thing. Oh, and also another reason, because your questions may have gone ignored before, I will, in the future, take one question at a time. And if it is a bad question, I will say, no comment. So therefore... For all that you have been turned done, for all that you trolls have done, you in turn have done for me an excellent service. As with the Wolf Cub Scout salute, I salute you. Have a good day. Stay safe. Also, before I forget, the current Saint Star contest between me and the imposter in the brown stripes. I know your name, Mr. Toys R Us Giraffe. His name, only cut in half, use the first half. Anyway, the contest shall continue for the fun of it. And I hope he will enjoy the song I have in my mind that God has entrusted me to relay for him to sing, that he enjoys it and sees the meaning. The Lord loves us, our own name, our own true honest name.
Later, Chris would send this email to Vivian G, thanking her and Clyde for trolling him. To clarify, Vivian, I am thanking all trolls for their documentation of whatever truths I have shared with them in the past. Granted, they've twisted the words around and made me look bad, stupid, and worse. But the original words and drawings that I have stated and created from my hand have been documented, especially on the Encyclopedia Dramatica page. And those documented words and images from years of information separate me from any imposter, especially the brown-striped Jeff. And I'm thanking all trolls for even trying to break my spirits, to have me emotionally pick my back up eventually, which was weeks ago now, just to make me grow up emotionally better and more well off, better business game plans, and all that jazz. I have had my revelation for the purpose of trolls and internet bullies from God the other day, and with a full, confident heart, well-confirmed thoughts and ponders, and energetic gusto, I thanked you all. Smiley face. God has put you all on this earth, and appointed you all each to pick on my nerves and challenge my reactions. Now that I fully understand all that beyond, I'm just doing it for the fun of it, I'm just bored, I just like trolling, and such, I can finally move on with you all in my background and continue with my drawing and coloring of my stories and books, and stand up for my full power on the city of Quickville and beyond, and especially in becoming an emotionally stronger man among all that. Thank you, Vivian. Thank you, Clyde. Thank you all. Again, my humblest condolences for Clyde. Keep a happy thought and stay safe. Love and peace. Christian W. Chandler. This was Vivian's response. You still haven't learned anything, have you? Casey call 1.5. Chris has another call with Casey on August 4th, in which he, again, pretends to be Liquid Chris in order to get her to his house. In their last call, Chris had given Casey Kim Wilson's contact information so the two could talk and Kim could verify Chris's identity. Casey tells him that she had talked with her, but slips up and calls Kim Emily. Despite this, Chris still never suspects that the two are the same person, and quickly believes the lie that Casey feeds to him in order to cover her slip-up. The reason for this call being dubbed 1.5 is because it was leaked by the miscreants after what we will come to know as Casey Call 2 was already public. Because of this, the call happens between 1 and 2, and it's called 1.5. Exposing Jeff. Chris uploaded this video on August 4th, where he, again, tries to get Liquid Chris to come to his senses and admit that he is an imposter. He mentions someone named Dan Topoulos.
Is that right?
He mentions someone named Dan Topoulos, though who this person slash identity actually is currently unknown. He reveals that he's been talking to Casey, and blesses their relationship as long as Liquid Chris admits that he is a fake. In a long-winded segment reminiscent of a church sermon, he tries to get Liquid to give up the game in the name of God. All with the song Lift Up Your Eyes by Planet Shakers playing in the background, which he instructs Liquid to sing for the final song in the SingStar Challenge.
Well, this is Brown Stripe. I want to get a few things off my mind while I'm thinking about it. I know the truth. Your real name is Jeff. You've been talking to this guy named Dan Topoulos at yahoo.com about since money or whatever. And thinking about, oh yeah, we're gonna troll me some more, the real me. And also, I've been talking to Casey. I did not really have any intentions at all, except for to let her know about you've been lying through your teeth that you stole my name, my identity, counterfeited those documents, driver's license. And yet, even after all that, she still cares about you, man. But I will bless you and her with eternal happiness of being together. All I would ask you to do is just come clean. No false documents. Your real name. Your real name. You're not the original Chris, aren't you? I am. So give it up already. I know. Importantly, Casey knows. And just to go ahead and get out of the way, let's see, this is song number 4 from me. I'm going to go ahead and give you a sample of what I would like you to play for song number 5. This was a song that I was turned on to by my Australian gal pal, Panda Halo. Did the best Chris Chan Science Your Heart ever among other fan arts. Gotta be cover number 10 for the real books. The real books available on the real Wikipedia, the official Science and Rose Chew site of 2009 and beyond. Anyway, I want you to think about this song that I'm about to tell you about. It's called Lift Up Your Eyes from the Planet Shakers. And you have to pay $1 for this song because it's not available for free download. And it's a wonderful song. I also wanted to let you know, Jeff, that is your real name, or if you are actually another Christian Weston Chandler in name only, that I have been labeled a number of times before by my past real, or not real, by my past not real internet gal pals, even though I've associated with real ones, and their names still hold a place in my heart. Proven troll, Wonka Weiss. Real woman, Sarah Jackson, died in an automobile accident with a truck. Her sister Rita, who is also high functionally autistic. I know I often use that as a crutch, and I have the papers to back it up, but that is not the case. I should not need to prove that, although I can prove it. I have the legal documents. The only thing that I am guilty of that just makes me give off the wrong impression is that I'm sometimes actually slow in the head. I can't think of everything so quickly. I admit it. I'll even say the word. I'm retarded. But am I perfect? No. Nobody's perfect. But God and Jesus love those who are proud of their own name. Is that really your name, Christian Weston Chandler? Or is your real name Jeff something? Because God will not love you very much, or will have less respect for you if you steal other people's names and take credit for their own work. I actually have police people investigating you, and detectives, Green County Sheriff and his group. My father voted for him. He met him at the fruit stand when he was being I forget his name though. But I shook his hand. I shook his hand, and he accepted a job to go against you. I can lift up the charges easily. All I ask you to do is just take away your claim for being a provisional criminal, because you are not. If I wanted paper that you made your medallion from, I would go to Walmart and get 500 sheets for $5, or even Sam's Club, get 750 sheets for $7. My hand drawing. The real hand drawing. Copyrights. Christian Weston Chandler of Rockersville, Virginia, who went to Manchester High School in Chesterfield County, Virginia, within the state of Midlothian, around Midlothian. I don't know if I could have heard that right. But yes, definitely part of part of the retardedness that I sometimes get in my head. I have moments of quick speed thoughts when I'm actually on a roll, but I know I'm not perfect. You if you really wanted to pretend to be me, you would not one up me. You play real guitar. Good for you. You speak French and German in addition to Spanish. Good for you. But the real fact is that the real Christian Wesley Chandler, which is me, can be so much better. Yes. But all I ask is that you just give it up. Let go. God loves you by your real name. So quit assuming the one that you stole, please. And also, please, give Casey, continue to give her kindness and respect that you have been giving her, as she has told me in confidence. And I hope that you two will be happy together. Please, just stop this game. Although the Sing Star contest will continue just for fun. Just for fun. This is what I'm letting you know about the fifth song I want you to sing. You can tell me what you want me to sing next, after your next track, if you decide to upload one. But in the meantime, I'm just gonna say, I wish you luck in your love that you have found successfully. I'll find mine one day. I know it. Nobody's gonna keep me down. It feels like it's been forever, but I stumble out of the darkness into the light, fighting for the things I know are right. Even though I make mistakes, I say the wrong choice of words. I'm bad enough to admit it. Nobody's perfect. The one who loves your name.
The one who loves your name.
But I just have you know, I am being a winner. I actually have friends in real life. And they are helping me branch out to make the official Sawchew merchandise. So please, also stop with your fake, shoddy stuff. Because it's not worth it. And quit saying that you go to church. My church. Because you are not. You live near Detroit. That's up in Michigan. You don't drive over 7 hours just to come to my church on Sundays. Just stop it. Stop pretending. Please, Jeff. And please, continue to keep Casey happy. Your play.
Immediately after this, he would upload a second video showing how he draws Sonichu, in yet another attempt to prove to Casey and everyone else that he is Sonichu's real original creator.
Good evening. But between this and, other clips I would like to present to you a few examples of hand archery. Anyway, let me just, first portion is live, so let me just see if we can get that set up here. Huh, well, let me look at that. Anyway, see my hand, okay. Let's see how we draw a sonichu here. As we have been doing the whole time, ever since 2000. Let's do this and that. And the ear there. Saturate the things there. Give him a masculine looking chest. I kind of messed up on that one, but oh well. I'll work with it.
the thumbs up there. All that there. The old brown stripes. Give him that there. The old tail. Put his little shoes on. Give him a little lift up the foot look there. Put my little C in a circle and my John Hancock. And let's give him a little drop shadow underneath. Now we break out the markers. Covering the old mouth with the flesh color. Crayola rocks. Cover his arms. His belly. Belly and chest. Whatever you want to go. Whichever you want to call it. Yeah. Sticking out. I'll put it back later. Okay. Regular yellow. Oh, I forgot the eyebrows. There you go. Look at that. Making up smart. He's slick. Slick character. Yes. Just hurry up to the coloring. I didn't close the hand. There you go. Could do a little better on this, but no press for time. But it basically definitely looks like but yeah, it's my style, my handwriting, my hand drawing. It's uncopyable. Give those little red cheeks. Lime green soulful eyes. Good shade of brown on the old stripes. And the edge in the bottom portion of the tail. The shoes there. Barry blue. Favorite shade, Sideshow sneakers. Funny, funny shape will make you do funny things. And we'll, accentuate the blackness on the tips of his ears, his nose. And, where's that gray? Oh, here it is. Make his sneaker soles. Shades of gray. Oh, and while I got this up and about, let me make a switcheroo here. Actually, you know what? Let's do one more thing. Arts and care for Casey. Anyway, now for the old switcheroo. Let's close this up here. And put in the hand-drawn pages of book number 0. Let me just re-angle this a bit. The old history of the hand-drawn. Print these out. You get blank sight. You get blank edges. Unedited. As they originally were before I scanned them and typed the text into them. Oh, that's a good page. Very good page. Yeah. But just kind of like the introduction of Itzel Saga back in episode 2 of Itzel Saga. Sorry, why are you not? I was sorry, you not? Oh, she day.
Kissy kissy. Yum. You know, you can pause any time, but I'm just going though quickly because I don't want to kill over 10 minutes in this. Anyway, from there. Oops. There goes the creation. There goes the creation. Oh well. Anyway. Anyway, I wanted to again give a shout out to Casey. I care about you very much. Your feelings mean a lot to me. You mean a lot. I'm sorry, Casey, but I'm afraid that, I tried to ease you into the subject, but unfortunately, I just could not do that. I just had to give it to you straight, as my friend made me realize when I talked to her earlier tonight, in addition to you. I'm sorry, Casey, but, you know, you fell in love with Science Shoe and Rose Shoe in the world of Quakeville. It's mine. Originally mine. I'm the guy. March 17th, 2000, in front of Miss Naomi Charlie Fool's classroom at Manchester High. Freshly drawn. You saw it from my own hand. I'm the artist. But anyway, as to further elaborate, the imposter's real name is Jeff. I know this because I learned his name is Jeff from a DANTOPULTIS at yahoo.com. And also, if you take a good look, if you've ever seen him in person, look at his ID. Look at his ID. You'll know that it's fake. Look, ask him to hand it to you personally. It's fake. I can hand you mine anytime, out of my wallet. It's real. As well as my diplomas and degrees, they're just right here in my room. Right here. In these four walls that Sanchu and Roshu in the world of Quickville have evolved from. I'm sorry, Casey. I didn't mean, if I hurt you, I'm sorry. But I wanted to make sure you knew the truth. You had to know. You have been dating and having relationships with the imposter. His name is Jeff. I'm sorry. But I care about you. I do. Just like you have been talking to me the past two nights. Rigatoni. But yeah, I would definitely recommend you confront Jeffrey. I'll leave it up to you, Casey. Be safe. Stay strong. Take your time. I care about you, as I cared about all my other gal pals in my life. From Megan Schroeder, Tiffany, Miranda, Sarah, Kelly, even all the ones I made on the internet. My Australian gal pal, Sarah Cassandra McKenzie, Panda Halo, died in that brush fire. And Sarah Jackson died in the automobile accident. And Ivy O'Neill recently. I had to go listen to my father's me head theories. I'll leave it up to you. I care.
Look at the way he holds his pen. Good God. Casey, call 2 and 3. Chris and Casey have another phone call on August 4th, though not much happens in it. However, afterwards, Casey releases a video that Chris sent to her on August 3rd. In it, he's still pretending to be Liquid Chris, and so in order to hide his face, he distorts the video so as not to reveal himself. She seems to have seen the recent video in which he admits to impersonating Liquid Chris to talk to her, and so calls him for the second time that day. She admonishes him for pretending to be someone else, and seems very distraught at the fact that he tried to get her to come to his house while lying about his identity. As anyone would be. She tells him that she's no longer coming to his house. Chris tries to defend himself by citing his autism, his tendency to be slow in the mind, and his past traumas with fake women. But Casey doesn't let him use any of that as an excuse.
Hey, Casey. It's me. I'm sorry my computer seems to be acting up. But, you know, sometimes this will happen. But, you know, just give me the shout out that I promised. I love you, Casey. You're a good girl. And the more I talk to you, the more I get, the more I appreciate you very much. And there are so many things yet you have to learn. You have to learn about me. But it will be learned in the near future when you come. By the way, my parents will be here when you come by later. So they'll be very happy. They'll be very happy to meet you. You know, at least my father will. He's a nicer parent nowadays, even though back in the old days he used to be such a stick in the mud. But seriously, yeah, he's a good guy. My mom's a good woman too. Be a bit of a redneck sometime, but you know, you earn her trust, she'll be good to you. But I'll welcome you. Lovingly with open arms. I'll see you later. I can't fight this feeling anymore. I've forgotten what I started fighting for. There's something drifting up to the shore. I'll see you later.
Chris Chandler. In the wake of the final SingStar videos, a few things happen. Solid Chris was forced to re-record his cover of Smell Yo Dick by Risqué because he continuously replaced the word dick in the song with his preferred euphemism, duck. His re-upload is very amusing to watch, as Chris looks completely miserable for the entire duration, mortified at having to say the word dick. In this video, uploaded on August 6, Solid Chris yells at Liquid to re-record his cover of Lift Up Your Eyes by Planet Shakers because he added lines calling out Solid Chris for trying to steal Casey from him, and did not record a cover of the entire length of the track. He also seems to have been told by Casey that Liquid Chris's real name is actually Chris, not Jeff. So he walks back that talking point as well before explosively declaring that he is not Ian Brandon Anderson.
Chris Chandler! Firstly, your video is only half the length of that track. The full length of that track is almost 10 minutes. Redo the video for the full 9 minutes something length. And commentary, you can put them in a separate video. Separate. So, sing the whole 9 minutes something song. And another thing, Chris, your real name, as I have been told by Casey, is only Chris Chandler. No Chin, no Tafer, just Chris. So, admit that. And another thing, my name is not Ian Brandon something. I am Christian Weston Chandler. So get it through your damn fucking skull and call me the real name that has God that's been given to me and the bear at Regency Square Shopping Center during 1989. You damn fucking bastard! Get it right! I'm Christian Weston Chandler. You are only Chris Chandler. Your medal is made out of paper. The whole length of time, the real medal has been made out of Crayola fucking model magic and acrylic paint. If I wanted paper, I would go to Walmart and pay $5 for 500 sheets. Redo the 10-minute song and save the commentaries for a separate video. And everybody on the internet knows that I am the real deal. You are the imposter, so give up the damn game already before I really call the police. Before I tell the police all the information I have gotten since I finally got them involved. And then send them on your case, put you in jail, even though I would prefer not to see you in jail because Casey respects you so much, man. She cares about you so much. She has told me so herself over the telephone. If I did not have that beforehand, I would have just been gladly prepared, gladly and only gladly, before I talked to her, gladly to see your ass behind bars. But after talking to Casey and hearing her honest respect, I would hate to see you in jail. Out of respect and a care, because she would be heartbroken. You are a lucky son of a gun, Chris Chandler. So quit this stupid impersonation game. Call me by the real name that God and the bear has given me throughout my whole life. The current full name of Christian Weston Chandler, my first name being Christopher, and my Spanish nickname being Ricardo. But in the end, just call me the full name, Christian Weston Chandler. This game is not fun. If you are not careful, you really are going to go to jail. You will be trying court, and you will be going to jail, or serve community service, forcedly. I was nice about it. I told you the details. And what do? You kick me in the balls again! And I do not appreciate that. So stop it. Stop it. Come clean. Rip off your paper medallion. Rip it up like a shred of paper. Look at my medal. I cannot even twist it because it is made from mono magic. Not some cheap paper I could get at Walmart for $500 for $5 for 500 sheets. Sing the whole 9 minute something song.
Showdown. The true Quick confronts the fake. On August 9th, Solid Chris would upload the video Quick's Final Warning to the Second Chris as a final warning to Liquid Chris, telling him to back off because he told his dad to get the police to investigate him. He also says that if any man calls him gay, he will fight them. However, if a woman calls him gay, he will kiss that woman in order to record it to prove his straightness, thereby committing sexual assault. Chris would also release an audio of a phone call between himself and Liquid that occurred the previous evening.
Alright, firstly, let me dispel the rumor, and I'm only going to explain this once. Just as I have said it on the Quickopedia page, the official new Sanchi and Roshu site, ever since I removed it 2 months ago because the trolls got into my web hosting account. I, meaning myself, B, specified for who I am, A as in singular, and Chandler being my last name. There is no such thing as Ian Brandon Anderson. You all have ruined those three names. Those three names in my lifetime. You ruined them for me forever. They all just sound about as bad as the word naive to me now. Every time I hear any of those three names now, it's gonna remind me of this whole mess. So, to everyone who's been calling me that, no, Christopher Christian Weston Chandler, born on February 24th, 1982. Blood type A negative, born in Rutgersville, Virginia. No. Born in Charlottesville, Virginia, grew up in Rutgersville, Virginia, went to Chesterfield County for high schooling, Manchester High School, degree, diploma, and went to Piedmont Virginia Community College for the degree and a certificate. Do not believe his counterfeits. Now, my final warning, my last wise words for Mr. Christian Weston Chandler. He was born with that name. He lives somewhere around D.C. I know a lot about him. Look, Mr. Christian, Mr. Chandler, I have already informed my father to go ahead with the police trials and to get the police that we have already involved in the case, getting them further involved. You pretty much just cashed in your chips when you made the phone call last night and harshly talked to me. You would not even listen.
You would call me the liar. You would continue to call me by that stupid Ian name. When everybody on the World Wide Web and around the whole world knows that I'm the real deal. They're just playing along with you just to try to get on my nerves. No more. No more. Never. Okay? So quit this stupid game. You are ruining your relationship with Casey. She's all heartbroken about over this whole feuding between us. She's very sad. She's very depressed. You have not called her for days. What are you doing, man? She cares about you very much and honestly from her heart. She asked you. Get you to stop playing this game. Why did you start? Were you bored? Were you just an outcast? What? But listen, you were never born Christopher Weston Chandler. I was born Christopher Weston Chandler. Then the Bear Regency Square changed my name to Christian. I had legally changed a few years later after the Englishman behind it misunderstood Christopher and called me Christian. We already have so many people involved. And at this point, I'm just gonna do it. Bring you in. You're gonna get arrested. We're gonna see you in court. But hopefully you will only have to serve community service. Because I really would hate to see you and Casey's relationship a lost cause. Dude! The last warning. You've already broken my balls so many times in response to my previous warnings. Bringing the police in further. You will be... I've already said I'll have to repeat myself. But... My mother, Barbara, and my father, Robert, we will all see you in court. And to everybody else that is not troll, and all the true fans, please come back and stay with me. Because because I know that some of you have left and you were replaced by trolls, or otherwise you turned troll. Please come back. We're good people. I'm good people. I'm honest. And if you, and just like in Jesus, you continue to have faith in me, all rewards will be shown. And the rewards are shown on a daily basis for the small update. Even if I miss one day, something will happen the next day on the Wikipedia. Okay. No more of that stupid Ian name. Anybody else who mislabels me as that name again, or anybody else who mislabels me a homosexual in person, if it's a guy, he will get... Or he can accept the answer straightforward on my honest heart, and just leave it at that and spread the word around further. Or, if it's a lady, I will give her the option of either accepting the truth or allow me to kiss her strong and long on the cheek, the face cheek, and video record it. So there. So, everybody get your skulls. I'm the real deal. He's the imposter. Stop this stupid game. Stop encouraging Christian Weston Chandler number 2 over there. Stupid dog tag. Get this stupid... I'll forget about the stupid dog tag. The only reason I'm wearing it is because it represents, like, you know, I've experienced some of the good things in life. I played Lowry a few times. I've traveled to Ohio. Thanks to that stupid Matt's. And I've had a few drinks. The only check mark that's not left, that's the only thing that only mark that has not been checked yet for a good life, is the Virgin Breaker. I'm straight. We got that cleared up. Don't ever call me Ian. Don't ever call me Guy. Have a safe day. Stay safe. Peace.
Look at the truth. This is a video posted by Chris on August 10th, where he again tries to prove his identity. This time, his method involves comparing images and personality traits of himself in the present to himself prior to Liquid Chris's arrival. This is done in order to dispel the rumor that, once Chris lost his original channel, Liquid Chris's channel was created for him to continue, with the IBA Chandler channel being a fake. He cites things like the fact that Liquid was able to get a sweetheart, the fact that he himself cannot play a real guitar, and the fact that he has man boobs, while Liquid Chris does not, as deciding factors. So, in highlighting all these negative traits, he declares himself as the real CWC.
Alright, let's get some similarities and differences compared. Personality types. In the longer run, who has been the cooler man? Who has originally done everything in the Sachin and Roshu comics? As you notice in all the videos, I have been the core man. I have been more calm, and even my voice sounds more similar to everything in the past recordings, including my 25th birthday. And look at my face, the very same face from February 24th, 2 years ago. And another thing, yes, I have never learned to play a real guitar. But that doesn't mean I could not rock. So that's a good reason why I played a Guitar Hero. Started out PlayStation 2, where it originally started, you know. And another thing, I have still been having a harder time of trying to find a boyfriend for a girl and to make it to a sweetheart from the ground up. Yeah, he was able to get a girlfriend like that. Big difference. The longer run, the real Christopher Christian Weston Chandler had a harder time. And still is having a bit of a hard time. And also, if you look at the 8-year-old photo, and I have recently looked back upon it, the 8-year-old video, and in previous videos and photographs, including on the Encyclopedia Dramatica page, yes, it is true. I'm no longer ashamed of it. I was born with the body type that has man boobs! Body type! Might say a little bit of an A, a little bit of size A. But I'm a man. So there. I'm still a man. My dick was on that Encyclopedia Dramatica page. It was falsely brought on because the trolls posed as women who falsely gained my trust. I know, it's my fault. My fault that those trolls got the information. But still, they documented it for the longest time since about 2006 or 2007. But I first found the ED page in 2007. Yeah, more 2007, because it was just getting started on that late October then. Plus also, green and purple striped shirt. The picture was blurry, but that's still my face. So, there you go. That's a few big differences between me and him. Is he the man with the body type of man boobs? A negative, bud. Born on February 24th, 1982. Born with the name of Christopher Weston Chandler. Went to Regency Square. Had the inspiration for a name change in 1989 by the English-speaking conductor, Leonard Bernstein. Does he? No. And you know, his diploma and his degree that he had displayed counterfeited from the pictures that were taken from the slideshow on a DVD, which is only distributed family and close friend wise. It would not have leaked if the troll had not posed as my very first female crush all the way back into my Greene County primary days. So there. Remember, who has a longer history? I do. Who has the body type that has been mocked for a long time? I do. He does not have any of these things. He has nothing. All he has is just a piece of paper that I could get 500 sheets of at Walmart for $5. So I'll leave you with that. Quit with this game, man. And quit with the with supporting the imposter trolls. I have thanked you for the documentations. You can go troll Joshua Martinez for all I care, because he is a liar. He is a liar. At this point, I don't care much about him, so go ahead. Troll him. Peace out. Have a good day and stay safe.
Casey meetups. The exact date of this is unconfirmed, but documentarian Gino Samuel places it just after the previously mentioned video, so I'm going to as well. Apparently, Casey met up with Chris in real life twice, and almost bumped into him a third time. This is Casey's recounting of the times that they met up, during which Kim, aka Emily, was also present to help supervise, just in case. It goes as follows. As someone put two and two together, Casey has met Chris Chan on two occasions, and one near miss. Also, just to answer any questions from the guitar thread, I am the one who developed an allergy rash to Chris. I'm not kidding. It kept getting worse each time, and I actually went to get shots and have to use a cream now for erasing the scarring. It was on one side of my face, where I kept my phone, and along my left shoulder and both arms. It's not Axe. It might be his laundry soap or something on his skin. I'm thinking it's his skin because it's where his bare hands touched me. And now, onto our show. This is the rushed short versions. Kim can help fill in details. First day. Went to mall with Kim. We met, talked, and called Liquid. We planned to have Liquid not know that Casey was there to try and be peacemaker, and he would call, find out, and be angry. Chris had given us the slip, so we called him and finally got him to go back to the mall. It was scary seeing him for the first time. He sweats a god-awful lot and gets tired just walking. You notice the medallion right away. He comes speeding towards us. He looks me over, rape eyes my breasts, and tells me, "I thought you'd be a little more," makes a hand motions showing a skinnier girl, "but you're gorgeous." And I'm like, "What the fuck? You think I look more what?" And he says he thought I'd be skinnier, but I'm hot, etc. We go outside to take pictures. He puts his arm around me. I sob on the inside. He shows me his eyes up close. They both look hazel. They are not different colored. So we walk to Starbucks. He draws me a picture of Sonichu. He shows me the medallion. He constantly brushes his knee against mine and tries to rub my side, back, and shoulder. Rape eyes are constant. I send Liquid a text message to call. Liquid calls, I confess where I am, and Liquid starts screaming and demanding to talk to Chris. Chris grabs the phone and starts screaming in a crowded mall. People are uncomfortable, staring, and walk away. I'll let Liquid detail the call. Liquid talks to me again and is a jerk. I cry and ask Kim to go to the bathroom so I can sob. Inside, we call Liquid and ask him what he told Chris. I smudge my makeup and go back out.
Chris is coming towards us. I act like I'm upset and crying. Chris mentions how liquid sucks, etc. He says he has to go. He grabs me and pulls my face into his chest, and he smells like horror. He repeats that now we are friends and he will help me out. He then smells my hair and brushes his lips against my ear. I look on to Kim with horror. She looks at me in horror. Chris bounds away without so much as a goodbye. Overview. Chris touches me. A lot. Chris is boring and goes on and on about Sonichu and how I'm meeting the true creator. Chris repeats about his stupid eyes. Thinks he's better than Liquid because both of Liquid's eyes are green. Chris does not approve of Liquid. Chris fucking tried to kiss me. Chris scares everyone. I'll let you digest this, and Liquid can chime in, and I'll write up the near miss meeting and part two. Near miss. My cousin and I went to Charlottesville to see Kim. We almost ran into Chris Chan. I saw him near the city hall with his stupid park poster. We ran away. He went in the building and we waited, but we did not see him come out. The end. Second time. Note, Liquid is now gone. We met Chris at the mall again. There was horrible traffic, so I was late, and Chris left for his British comedy. I called him and begged him back. He would, for Casey. He showed up, rape eyes, told me I was pretty like a teacher he once had, rape eyes, etc. We walked around the mall. All of a sudden, Chris calls out, "Oops, my knuckle touched your ass." There are kids around. We hush Chris to shut up. More rape eyes. He talks about how Liquid trolled us both, but now I have the real deal to help me get through this. More attempted touching and stroking of my bare arm. More boring. More Chris asking for my number, and I say I have overprotective parents who pay for it, so I have to keep my restricted number and no. He keeps hinting to dating me and how pretty I am. Kim gets distracted by a friend. Chris and I walk along without realizing. He asks me if I want to see his car. I of course say yes, but then realize Kim isn't there. I text her. Chris calls his father and lies and says he's in traffic and will be late going home. Chris takes me to his car. It's awful. Stickers of Pokemon and Sonichu everywhere. There was a homemade one of his tripod site address. The bumper sticker is held up by duct tape. He tries to hold my hand while we cross the street. I glare at him and break away. He asks if I want to sit in his car. I text Kim. I say no. He insists. I sit with the door open and my legs out, ready to run. He tells me the last girl in his car besides his mom was Megan. I cry. I ask to take his picture. I do. He asks to take a picture together, so I do. He tries to grope my chest and misses horribly, only grazing it. I glare at him and tell him not to do that. He insists he slipped. I say let's go find Kim. He tries to grab my hand again and I shake it away. He needs to rest, so he sits down on a wall outside the mall. He notices my bag from Bath & Body Works and asks what I bought. He smells them, and one of them is called P.S. I Love You, and he jokes, "P.S. I'm loving you." I laugh nervously, and we find Kim. By this time, Liquid asks for me to put on the phone so he can hear everything, so I do and hide the phone. I mention Chris liked the perfume I'm wearing, so he leans in and audibly makes a sniffing sound. I scream, "Oh look, makeup," and run off. He asks me my favorite color. I say teal. He says, "How a tealing." I die on the inside. Chris keeps trying to get close and get my number. He messes with my hair, and Kim yells at him for touching me. He touches me 5 seconds later. Then he leaves eventually after more boring and rape eyes. In a later call, he invites me to stay the night. I say no. He says I can come over any weekend and go to his church. He doesn't know his own religion. He sucks. The end. Overview: Chris touches me too much and tries to smell me. Chris is rape eyes always. Chris is a moron. Chris wants to be a sub for Liquid. Chris sweats so much and wipes it off on his vest. He's gross. Any questions? I may remember more later. And after the first time, I couldn't stop shaking. It was weird. Liquid declares victory. And now that it had been a few days since all the videos of the SingStar challenge had been completed, Liquid Chris posted a video called Verdict. I, CWC, win the SingStar contest. Also, more updates on Sonichu and Going Places. Here, he declares himself the winner of the challenge because Solid Chris's judges had yet to upload their rulings.
Captain's Log, Stardate, August 11th, 2009. Hello, my loyal fan date space. I would like to address the imposter, Ian Brandon Anderson, for a moment. I officially declare myself the winner of the SingStar Challenge contest because your judges have not followed any rules, uploaded any videos. My judges have been following the rules and given me scores. Therefore, because you have no scores, you're out of the running, and I am the true Christian Weston Chandler. Now, I don't care if you're stealing my original work and comic pages and arts and uploading onto a dimpy little website where no one will see them while the true comics are about to be published by Dark Horse Comics. Yes, you heard it right. Dark Horse is where they are working venturously, furiously to create and draw and write the first Sanchu Episode Zero comic within accordance from Sega and Nintendo. Now, they are also working with certain Microsoft as well. My current status on the project is they may hire me as production manager. So, you know, keep my fingers crossed. But, and other things, I present to you another true Sonichu merchandise selling site is quickstore.blogspot.com. It's your one-stop shop for anything Sonichu, Roastchu, or Quickville related. I will show you a bit of the site right here. Now, another note there, I'm going to start selling Lego sets of Quickville along with Guides to the City. So, be looking forward to that one, true believers. The Sonichu Crystal Chronicles game has come along pretty well. It's going to be a RPG-style game, role-playing game, and outside the city of Quickville. And it is currently being produced in tandem with Microsoft for the Xbox 360. Look forward to the official revealing of it in the Austin Game Developers Conference. Anyway, yeah, so that's about it for now. Still making lots of monies, rolling in the dough, you know. And who knows what the future holds. Peace. And to my darling sweetheart Casey. Eventually, a magical lighthouse that randomly shone its healing guiding light upon my previously shattered heart and tortured soul, and mended them back to good shape and form. One girl walked into my life, like a sailor soldier having just vanquished a heart snatcher. Bit by bit, I've noticed your shining lustrous hair, your shiny blue chaos emerald-like eyes, and a personality, strong and caring, like a true buttercup bloom. I followed my recovered heart's instincts and followed you. As I got to know you over the months, and my heart was growing stronger as I was falling for you, I blushed more strawberry pink than I have ever before. And everything around me was shining like a sun's mellow color, yellow. For you, I would travel even 1,000 miles just to be with you. Fortunately, you live only about 2 hours away from my house, and I meet you when we date. This feeling, it was, it still is, so pure and true. It was as if I was born to love you. When you smile, I feel like I'm walking on sunshine. As I give my replying smile, I gaze into your eyes. And your hair is the softest and most warm tingling. Cloud 9? I feel like I'm on 10. Casey, my love, would you marry me?
KCWC Top 10 Special. This is a series of videos that Chris posted on August 11th, in which he roleplays as DJ Jamstasonichu, and himself as a guest host, on the KCWC Quickville radio station. He plays songs and dedicates them to people in his life, such as Vanessa Hudgens, Megan Schroeder, and Sarah Jackson. Resume. Also, on August 11th, Chris would upload his resume to the website monster.com. It would also later be leaked, and is available for perusal on the Quickie. Here are some highlights. Job objective, full story. I, Christian Weston Chandler, birth name Christopher, born on February 24th, 1982, in Charlottesville, Virginia, am an artist with vast experiences in multiple art classes with multiple media throughout my whole lifetime, from Greene County Primary School to Piedmont Virginia Community College, with a diploma from Manchester High School and a degree and certificate in Computer-Aided Drafting and Design, CAD, from PVCC. Since the inspiration and conception of Sonichu, the Electric Hedgehog Pokemon, on March 17th, 2000, I have grown further in his stories, plots, and adventures in a series of hand-drawn and computer-edited comic books. I also have had and passed 2 HTML classes and created from Notepad Scratch Quicks Pokesite 2, El Pokesite de RWC. Ricardo Weston Chandler was my Spanish nickname given to me during my 2 years of Spanish in Manchester High. And, most importantly, the first and original website dedicated to Sonichu, Rosechu, and their adventures, Quick's Sonichu site. I was also noted twice later in the periodicals of Nintendo Power Magazine and PVCC's The Forum for being the original creator of Sonichu and all. See periodical references below. With the Sonichu site originally located at http://sonichuchandler.tripod.com/quicksun.htm. It stayed online from about 2000 until early 2009, whereas my Sonichu and Rosechu fanbase has grown massively over the years. There were also internet bullies and trolls, and the trolls hacked into and compromised my original Tripod web hosting account. I've had to pull the plug on the Tripod account and move on to another web hosting site. The second web hosting account suffered the same fate as the first, and then I moved to GoDaddy. It got hacked too, so I pulled the plug on all my websites late May 2009. I stayed off for about 2 months, then a gal pal of mine about that time set up for me a start of what is now the new original Quick's Sonichu and Rosechu site. The Wikipedia-styled Quickipedia at http://cogsdev.110mb.com/quickipedia/index
php://main_page. As I have done on the previous site, I have re-uploaded my Sonichu comic pages, and I am steadily expanding further with more stories and character bio pages. I would like to be paper published with a comic book company like Archie, Marvel, DC, or Dark Horse Comics, complete with official Sonichu and Rosechu merchandise I can personally sign off on to follow for my worldwide fan base. Accept no imposterous substitutes who claim to be me or have any rights on my Sonichu and Rosechu stuff. I stand strong with my continued use of the copyright symbol on each of all my books and original singular art pieces, and the date of creation of March 17th, 2000. I have eyewitnesses at Manchester High of Sonichu's conception and creation on that date. It also bothers me that the trolls are even selling bootleg copies of my Life DVD, Christian Weston Chandler, Yep, I'm on TV, which was originally intent solely for family and close friend distribution. Trust one of the trolls to snag a copy and rip the videos from the 6-hour DVD-R. I became famous without having to leave my house or go out of state or city. After recent realization, on about July 17th, 2009, of what I want to do, I wish to make it all official, get me paper published with a comic book company like Archie, Marvel, DC, or Dark Horse Comics, with continuing work as a comic book artist and story creator slash editor, good pay, eventual official Sonichu and Rosechu merchandise that I can personally and officially sign off on and further enforce my 9-year-old copyright with a more peaceful future. Christopher Christian Weston Chandler, August 11th, 2009. Copyright March 17th, 2000 by Christopher Christian Weston Chandler. Additional information. Career highlights. Near daily updates on my Quickipedia website and my continued comic book page drawing, coloring, writing, and editing. Great hand-drawing skills, storytelling, and editing. Building design for my computer-aided drafting and design, CAD. Quick touch typing skills. Great Photoshop experiences. Good HTML skills. Good people/social skills. Memorizing and swift learning. Elbow greased strength. Quick update, 12th August 2009. This is a short update video where Chris tells people not to send him X-rated material. Apparently, people had been sending him art depicting Goro scenes. This is a Japanese term used to describe gore art, sometimes of a pornographic nature, and so he naturally wanted this to stop. Some trolls are so wrong that they make Chris right. This is one of those times.
Cat's log, stardate, April 12, 2009. Let's sort out one new topic of interest. If you're going to send me fan art, please keep it clean. No gross. It's triple X rated sexual content. And also, definitely worse off. Do not send me anything child sex. What the hell is wrong with you people? That's illegal everywhere. And it is so wrong. I mean, I'm like a family man, even though I'm not married. I have the mind like a family man. I mean, look at Homer Simpson. He's a family man. Do you think he does that with his children? Are you stupid? Or about Peter Griffin for Family Guy? Do you think he does that with even Meg? Or even back in the day, Lucille Ball, Desi Arnaz with Desi Arnaz Jr. Or even Dick Van Dyke, Maritime Warren, Richinger. Anyway, point is, it's wrong. It grosses me out. It grosses everybody out. So just stop it. What the hell is wrong with you people? It makes me think that there is something wrong with this dang world with such stupid, idiotic bastards like you drawing such things, creating them in their heads, and letting it... What the fuck? No more. Keep it clean. Keep it decent. I said polite kisses. You know, polite kissing scenes. And not X-rated, or even worse, what I just talked about. What in the hell is wrong with people? To go and draw such grotesque pieces of work that I cannot even feel comfortable calling them art. Because they are not. They're trash, 4-cent garbage. No more of that shit. Have a good day. Peace.
Quick update, 13th August 2009. In this video, Chris denies that the SingStar challenge is over, and once again denies that Liquid Chris is the true Christian Weston Chandler.
Captain's log, stardate August 13th, 2009. I'm sorry to have belabored this on a little bit longer, but, yes, the SingStar challenge has not been completed officially. The six judges now have to discuss amongst themselves in private messages on the YouTube, or in person if they have that capability, to discuss the matter and pick the winner majority. And after they have decided fully, they will each submit the name of the final winner on their individual YouTube accounts. Audio only, with their voices or with text. Either one is fine. But in any case, the winner is not final. Sorry, Mr. Christian Weston Chandler, born with that name. You are not the winner yet. And also, you can never be the original creator assigned you or roast you because your birth name is not Christopher. You cannot have anything like that without the birth name of Christopher. So, neither can you have that with both eyes being green, and my left eye is blue, and my right eye is brown. My right is green. My right eye is green. Color change, you know. Anyway, also with that, as promised on the station KCWCK station during this light lunch hour, we have found a couple of tracks from White Stripes, and we'll be playing them for Miss Kiss Me Kate right now. So take it away, White Stripes.
Thank you. creaking of the kitchen floor. I don't care what other people say. I'm gonna love you anyway. Don't chill me again in the cold, cold night. In the cold, cold night.
Sing Star results. Finally, all the judges involved in the challenge would cast their votes. Unsurprisingly, all of Liquid Chris's judges voted for him to win. However, in Solid Chris's camp, while Kim Wilson and the Unknown Man voted for him, Kate Bay decided to vote for Liquid Chris instead, causing Solid to send her this email on August 14th.
You know yourself, after the extensive online history, that I am the real deal. So why did you final vote for that brown imposter? I am on an emotional edge right now, and I apologize for raising my voice like that. I implore you, Kate, please change your vote. I had just dedicated 2 White Stripes songs for you during a recent KCWC Light Evening Lunch Hour. And I will not put down your brother's ideals either, but make him take a second look between me and him and make sure he thinks heavily about it. Sigh. Stay safe, Christopher Christian W. Chandler.
Quick public disclaimer. In a last-ditch effort to win the challenge and prove that he is the real CWC, Solid Chris uploads a video on August 14th where he literally doxes himself, giving out his address and phone number, even though they'd already been made public. He goes on about the history of the area that he's from and his creation of Sonichu, before inviting anyone who impersonates him or his family to meet him one-on-one in Charlottesville.
For anyone and everyone who is watching this YouTube presentation, my name is Christian Weston Chandler. I live at 14 Branchline Court, Rutgersville, Virginia, 22968, and my home phone number is area code 434-990-0198. I live in Greene County, in the state of Virginia, USA, in the heart of the Blue Ridge Mountains of Virginia, and the hometown area of President Thomas Jefferson, President James Madison, and President James Monroe. 15 miles away from my home is Charlottesville, Virginia, better known as Mr. Jefferson's Village, and home of Mr. Jefferson's Academic Village, better known as the University of Virginia. I was born in Mr. Jefferson's Village of Charlottesville on February 24, 1982, at the hospital named for Martha Jefferson. I am very proud to be born and live in this area. I consider it the cradle of the Declaration of Independence, which President Jefferson wrote, the U.S. Constitution of the United States, and the Bill of Rights, which President Madison wrote, and the Monroe Doctrine for all of North, Central, in South America, which President Monroe wrote. I originated and invented the character Asanchu, Roshu, and all therein on March 17th, 2000, as shown originally back on CWC's Pokesite 2, followed by the first original Sanchu website, CWC's Sanchu site, and are so noted by copyrights on a similar Sanchu face like the one and only medallion that I still wear, made from strong, long-lasting Crayola model magic and acrylic paints. As well as the title banners, logos, all of the comic pages, and cartoons of Sanchu and his friends since that date. I will challenge anybody to a face-to-face, one-on-one public debate meeting in Charlottesville, Virginia, to discuss any proprietary claims of anyone else. The place and time within Charlottesville, Virginia, will be also agreed on, publicly announced, and in a publicly attended place. Any imposters claiming to be me, my father, Robert Franklin Chandler Jr., or my mother, Barbara Ann Weston Chandler, are invited to meet me face-to-face, one-on-one, in a publicly announced and attended meeting. Be it known to all that I, the Christian Weston Chandler, have no Sanchu medallions, towels, printed comics, or any other Sanchu merchandise for sale previous to or at this time. Any items you might purchase before, now, or in the near future are fakes and fraudulent copies and are in violation of the laws of the United States of America. You may buy these items if you wish, at your own risk of receiving stolen merchandise and aiding and abetting a criminal. You, I'm talking to you. Instead of purchasing, you should instead turn this criminal over to the police and not allow him to sell in at any conventions of any kind, in the stores, or on the internet. He is just ripping you off. So far, this individual is falsely hiding under my name, my phone number, and my address. He uses a screen name and thinks he is safe. He is a coward and a rotten snake to be afraid to use his own God-given name, address, and telephone number, hiding behind the skirts of his own mother. I stand tall at 5 feet 10 inches, and as you can see, I look or act nothing like the imposter. The imposter criminal, which you see on his YouTube screen name of CCHANSONICHUCWC. To my fans, will you please help me and alert the police anytime you see him in action at a convention, store, internet, or anywhere else. Otherwise, be it known that I alone am the Christian Weston Chandler, sole originator and sole owner of any and all Sanchu, Roshu, or relay merchandise, symbols, icons, and comics. Please be advised that anyone offering for sale at any public gathering, store, as well as on the internet, will be subject to a severe violation of federal U.S. identity theft and counterfeit laws, and will be prosecuted to the full extent of the United States of America laws for identity theft, counterfeiting, and sale of said type of merchandise. Stay safe, have a nice day, and enjoy mine and the
original Sanshu and Roshu comics only on Wikipedia. That's C-W-C-I-P-E-D-I-A at http://codsdev.110mb.com, Wikipedia, index.php, capital M, main, underscore, capital P, page. 1M, 1P. Thank you.
Post-victory. After being declared the winner of the Stingstar Challenge, Liquid Chris would upload a video on August 14th called I, Christian Weston Chandler of Rutgersville, Virginia, have grown up. In it, he claims that he asked Casey to marry him and that she said yes. He also says that he got a job as the production manager and game designer for the Sanshu game that's been in the works. With that, he steps away from YouTube, claiming that he has grown up, and signs off before walking away into the sunset.
Captain's Log, Stardate, August 14, 2009. Hello, my loyal fan base. Today is you may be noticing that I am wearing a different shirt. I know that I am, but by all means, do not get your tidies in a knot, for it is a symbol of success. First of all, I thank my sweet Casey for saying yes to marrying me. It is but a given that we will live our whole lives together forever, where no man and no boyfriend may intrude. And our thing, baby. I got the job there as the production manager and the game designer of the official games. Yeah, with the assistance of my true and original characters Sanshu and Roshu and their world, I am now taking the first steps to growing up. This means that I will be moving out of my house and into a condominium in Redmond, so that I may travel and liaison between the headquarters of Microsoft in Redmond and Nintendo of America in Redmond, in development of a whole new series of Sanshu games for the Xbox 360, Nintendo Wii, and Nintendo DS. And possibly in the future, PlayStation Portable and PlayStation 3. Which brings me to my next point. I am going to community college all over again. So to learn about the business practices that my mother and father have been fine-tuned to for so long. With any luck, I can apply my new skills anywhere I wish. Which brings me to my mother and father. I'm going to fund their retirements with some of my sweet and tasty paycheck, which is a hefty sum that even allowed me to buy this new fancy shirt in the first place. However, this means I will be very busy, and I most likely will not have the time for YouTube videos, and therefore, I must announce that this is my official last video, and my videos are over, and I am leaving YouTube at least until I am well established in Redmond. So I wish to say a few things before my final departure. Do not get yourself in tears. To Harry Dorothy's, I hereby give you the rights of Sanshu
in Europe. I have sent you a copyright in the mail. It's kind of like the one that I have right here. But I only ask you will continue your good work on the Sanchu finale comic and insert me into it. To everyone who has messaged me with support and ideas, you will not be forgotten. I have read all of your messages and take all of your compliments in stride. To Garland and Chris Chan Game, and everyone who has sent me the artwork of the working on the Sanchu games, I truly appreciate what y'all been doing. I thank you for your compliments, especially. To everyone who is dedicated to taking down the imposter, Ian Brandon Anderson, you have warmed my heart to 100% with your bravery and your courage. And I hope someday he will come clean. But to all the boyfriend-free ladies who have contacted me in high hopes, please understand. There's someone out there for everyone. If my own experiences don't prove it, well, then nothing ever will. But to my friends in the animated series world, you know who you are. Thank you for everything that you have given me. Even though some of it was very objectionable to my characters, I would like to thank Spaz Kid and Fin Cupcakes for their involvement in my own involvement. Well, my bus leaves in 10 minutes to go to get to Redmond. So I will get going and I will leave you with the song. Peace and love, stay safe, and have a good day.
Again, don't know where, don't know where, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day. He's smiling true, just like you always do. Folks that I know, tell them I won't be long. They'll be happy to know that as you saw me go, I was singing this song.
No damn way, imposter. This is Solid Chris's reaction to Liquid Chris's sign-off, posted on August 14th. As you can tell by the title, he is not happy. He breaks out his old Kersey-Hame-Ha move to use on Liquid.
Oh no you don't, Chris! You're not getting away that easy! You do all that, I will sue your sorry ass! And I'm gonna tell Nintendo in Redmond right away to stop you! Because they know as well as I do. I sent them the letter previously, months and months ago, with the original printout of the number zero book. They know. They have the records. They know. I've been a customer of them for years. They had my money a bunch of times, long before I met up with Sony and gave them over to... Mikey did... Nintendo has like over $5,000 worth between me and my parents. But anyway, you will not succeed. You are the imposter! You are the imposter! Stop that brown stripe in the shirt with the paper medallion! Stop that imposter! Sanchu and Roshu are mine alone! I am the Christian Weston Chandler, born with the birth name of Christopher, February 24, 1982. I'm the one with Robert Franco Chandler Jr. as my father. I'm Barbara Ann Weston Chandler as my mother. 14 Branch Light Court, Rutgersville, Virginia, 229-6-8-434-990-0198. Stop that imposter bastard that's been posing with my name, my address, my phone number, everything! Stop him! He deserves nothing! Die, you! Especially after that disclaimer video I made, where I told everybody not to buy anything from you. I implore Nintendo, now Microsoft, and Sony, do not buy anything from him either. He's the imposter. I'm the real deal. Look at the history on ED and everywhere else. You will rot in jail, mister. You will rot in jail. Nintendo has known me for years. So much longer. Practically my whole lifetime. They know me. And they know you to be the imposter. You go into Nintendo's doors, they will kick your ass out. Nintendo, Microsoft, Sony, stop him. Put him in jail. Call the police on him. Everybody else in my true loyal fan base, do the same thing. Please help me. Put him in jail when you see his sorry face. And you know what? Let's top this off. Right now. No shin. We're going with the original. Just for that imposter that has worn the brown stripes all this time. Hershey Kamehameha! Call the police on him. Have a nice day.
And that does it for part 9 of the chronological Chris Chan iceberg. If you pulled up the original image of the iceberg in order to follow along, I'm sure you'll see that I actually added several points of interest myself. This is because I found the original to be a bit lacking in some areas, so I took it upon myself to do a little extra research in order to bring you a more complete picture of this time in Chris's life. The main sources of information I used were The Quickie and Gino Samuel's documentary. You can find Gino's channel linked in the description, and you can visit The Quickie yourself if you want to do some of your own research on Chris, because I'm not allowed to link to it on YouTube. I'll get working on part 10 of this series as soon as I can, in which we'll be going over a bit of the Emily saga, a bit of the gameplay saga, and the rest of the Liquid Chris saga. I hope to see you back here soon. Bye for now.